I've got my battery, negative terminal on the battery, disconnected. I've taken the cover off, which is just 2/4-inch fasteners at the front. Just gonna get some stuff out of the way here. We should be able to just pull this up. It's always nice to see a completely empty overflow reservoir. Completely empty. It's got a clip here. Get it around the light. I'm trying to get some light in here so you can at least see something. Maybe. Another light. Another clip. I'm just gonna sit right over there, out of the way. Be able to pull this up. This power steering. I got two hoses here, which I don't want leaking all over the place. This one, which I'm probably gonna have to just take off, and it's gonna want to leak if I do that. 10mm bolt holding this wire harness in. I don't know how much of this you can see. The positive side of the alternator terminal, that's a 12, I believe, down there. And we're gonna unplug the connector that I had out earlier. I'm gonna try to squeeze that and get that out. Yep, undid that. There is a lower connector on that to something, probably the AC compressor. It's my guess, I can't really see it, but we'll see it. So let me get that 10mm, get that wire harness undone, and a 12, get that undone. Let me show it to you, just so you kind of know what I'm doing here. Kind of, really tight. So right here, right here, 10mm, right here, 12, battery is disconnected. That's just to get the harness out of the way, and then we'll work on getting the serpentine belt. Hard to see, but down here, there's a 19mm, that's your tensioner. These are pretty stiff, so we'll be undoing that and just getting this belt out of the way. 10mm, undo the harness first. I got a wobble extension on here. Hopefully I can get in there with that. A little tight, not too bad though. Do the positive side to the alternator, positive wire. Get a magnet for that. Grab that with a magnet. Okay. To the side. Anything else? Nope, that's it for that harness. Just kind of pull that out of the way. I believe it's a 12mm right here in the front at the top, and I believe it's a 14mm, and then this bracket, this little bracket here, has to come off. I don't know if you can see that or not, but I'll show it to you when I get it off of there. But first, I gotta get the belt off, so it should be 19mm. So, I might have to take this, move the tools. I don't like leaving tools on there. Not a good idea. I think I need to move this power steering pump first. See if I can something to plug that line with. Because I know that it's going to leak initially. See if I can get a pan in here. It's a small pan to catch this as it. I don't make too much of a mess. Try to keep it to a minimum. Just got to get these somewhere in the middle. I don't want to crush it. But I do want to squeeze it off as much as I can without damaging it. Keep it to a minimum. All right, that'll stop most of it. Let me get this clamp off. See if I can get in here. I better have this ready to get undone here. I'm gonna lose all this fluid if I don't. All right, so I have it. Got my thing. This is probably gonna make a mess. I try to do this with the least amount of mess as possible, which probably means a lot. To tilt this up. I'm gonna get some out of the hose. I don't really care about that. I get my thumb over this thing. There, the hose I don't really care about. I can move that in a second. And this is probably a little, maybe I can do it this way. I leak it out all over the place. I'm just kind of slowing it down until I can get it in position here. Try to get it in a position where, or maybe not. Or maybe I just let it leak out.
There's not that much in there. I'm just going to let it leak out. I don't want to do that, but I don't see a good way to do that. Just wrap it up with a glove here for the time being. Try to keep it from leaking too much. Keep a tie glove onto it. Keep it from leaking too much. I'll have to fill it anyway. So I don't know how I'm going to get that pan out of there. Figure something out though. Leaking all over. Making a mess. Alright, we'll just pull that tight. That'll keep it from leaking too badly. That's even worse. This one. Just gonna clean it off. I don't want to get it on the belt. Kind of roll it back out of the way here. Fold it up. Back out of my way. Okay. Won't hurt it, but it will stay out of there. Now, I'll take this bracket, two 10 millimeter bolts here. That should allow me to get that pan out of there too and get things out of my way, I think. We'll see. In here. Oh, I know where it is. It's in the fluid in the pan. A little thing to put in there. Let's try not to drop them both in there. I'm going to drop that bracket in there, so we'll just set that bracket right there. Just set it out of the way. The bolt there, I'll get the other bolt, I'll dig that out of here. Now, I should be able to get this, I think, out, hopefully without spilling it all over. I hope. I say that, but you never know. You never know what's going to happen with them. Come on. Get it all over my hand, but clean my hand off. There it goes. A little better. Alright. Yay. And spilled all over. Alright, got my bolt out of it. We'll put that up with the bracket so I know where it goes. There. This, I really just want to set back and tuck it out of the way somewhere back in here. I hope. I think for now, I'll just set it back in here. I could undo another hose on it. Oh, there's a push pin down there. All right, there's this hose on the bottom of the front side of the power steering has a little push-in connector. Let me see if I can get that other one right in here with the tool. Now you can't see this, it's just pushed into the frame here. Support. Alright, got it out without breaking it. That's good. I should have some more flexibility here. Remove this. Kind of stuff it down here out of my way. I don't think I have to take this out. I'll know when I get the alternator actually loose if I need to take this out. If I do, I'll just move things. There's a bolt right here. I don't know if there's any others. Find out. We'll take that out of there if we have to, but I'm hoping we don't have to. All right, so let's go for the 12 millimeter. Actually, let's not go to that. Let's go see if we can get the belt on done. I think you got to keep steady pressure on this. It's got a hydraulic arm on it. You just push it. It'll keep going. It's strong though. And then slip it off. I slipped it off of the alternator pulley. There we go. That's all I wanted. Now, I'm just going to put this. I'm not taking this belt off. I don't have to. I'm just going to put it up there out of the way. Now we'll go for the 12 millimeter bolt. It's down here. Timing cover has a 10 millimeter bolt right above it. Right underneath it, that's a 12 millimeter. I'm gonna go with that first, see if we can do that. All right, 12 millimeter. Yep. Break that loose. to my 12 millimeter headed bolt. There's another one under this bracket right here. That's also 12. So we'll go with that one. That 12 headed bolt, longer one for the bracket. Grab that bracket and get it out. We'll just drop it down into the where I can't see it. Now down to the bottom of the alternator. There's a 14 millimeter. Is it a 14? I think it is. Yep, it is. Get this in a spot I can get out of here. All right, I'm gonna get a different. I'm gonna get a different one. All right, we're back. It's all the way down in there. Wasting my light here. I got that loose. Let me get a short handle on here. Reach down there with a short stubby ratchet now. Had to pivot the alternator a little bit to loosen that bolt up. So there's the 14 millimeter on the bottom of the alternator. Now, it's a U-shaped bracket that's faced this way and the alternator slides into it. Don't try to twist the alternator out, you'll break the table. If you have to work it towards the front and wiggle it out a little bit, and once you get it wiggled out, then you gotta fish it out of there. So just be careful with it. You don't wanna break the tab off of that bracket. Create a nightmare for yourself, so. Just be careful. I'll try to do the same and not just wiggle it straight to the front. Yeah, now it's out. I got it out that far. Now, I'm gonna unbolt this, the brackets for this AC line. There's one here and then one a little farther back. Both 10 millimeter. They will give me, should give me a lot more flexibility where I can move this line out of the way and work around it, I hope. Fell down in there. Might have just done me a favor, maybe. Turn it. Let's see. Oh, I need it. Not much. It's pretty tight. I don't know. I'm just going to fight with it. If there's anything specific to getting it out of there, trick, then I will come back, but I'm just going to fight with it for a while. Okay. You didn't see any of that, but basically, the alternator sits like this, kind of like that. I undid it, I pivoted it this way, and I moved it forward. It's tight against this line, but you can squeak it by. And I undid this bracket here, and then there's one more bracket that gives you some flexibility in moving this line. It's got to be pushed forward a little bit and in. And then I just pulled it up right through here, just like that. Just pulled straight up through there. Not too bad. Now I got to get the new one in there. I have an aftermarket one. I think Denso makes their... I think it's Denso, but this is a new, not remanufactured, and it's got a lifetime warranty. So it's the one I went with. Otherwise, it'd be about $100, $110 more for the alternator. If I get a lifetime warranty, we're going to use this one. I'll try to remember to show you the part number. It's a TYC 2-11391. So, we're just going to go back in the same way, basically. Just be careful getting it back in there. It's tight, but should go back in there. So one thing you need to do, you take your old alternator out, measure the distance here. I have a micrometer and measured it, a caliper, measured it. If it's longer than the one that comes out, there's no way you're going to get it back in there. I had to actually, these weren't pushed in completely all the way. I had to actually push them in a little bit to make them just a little bit smaller. And I'm talking minuscule smaller than what came out so I can get it back in there. But it was wider, and there's no way I would have been able to get that in there. It would never fit in that bracket. So you want to check that before you go putting it in. Not too bad. Now I've got to try to line that up. The hardest part is this bracket right here. At least so far. Trying to get it lined up and get it in there. There, that felt better. A little bit of wiggle motion there. It looks pretty close. Not close enough. Now I'm just holding the bolt against it. There we go. Wiggle it through. And wiggle the bolt through. Try to, I'm wiggling the alternator like forward and backward, little by little, as I turn the bolt in. I do not want to cross thread it, so wiggle the alternator. Make sure it gets the bolt gets started right and doesn't get cross threaded on you. All right, it's in. Beautiful. I'm not going to tighten. I'm turning that all the way in by hand. So that's how easy it should move. Not tightening it. That's much better though. Not too bad. All right. I'm gonna get my 12 millimeter up top. Actually my bracket. I'm get my bracket back on here. This bolt here, the short one, goes into the end of the head. The hole for the top of the alternator is this bolt here, which goes into the bracket. So I'm gonna start the bracket first into the end of the head with the shorter bolt. I hope. Come on. All right. Gotta turn in there, not tight, but enough to help line it up. Okay, still with that bracket. Now this goes through and into the bracket. Tip the alternator in. Line everything up, I hope. Let's see how badly I did. You want to come on. Just gotta get it lined up. By hand, of course, you do not want to cross-thread them. I've got them both started now. So this is the one through the tab on the alternator into this bracket. So now I'm going to tighten them up. And then we'll put the harness back in, put our belt back on, put everything back in place, put some power steering fluid in it. Getting a little ahead of myself. Push it, lean on it, hold it. Takes a minute to the hydraulic tensioner to kind of give you a little play. I should be able, hopefully, I got enough there. Got everything else lined up, I hope. Ah, the top's off. Get off, get up on there. Okay, so get everything lined up again. And back in place here. All right. I will check that. You want to check your belt, make sure it didn't come off any other pulleys by a groove or anything. I could see the bottom in the back. The back pulley there is fine. Check my crank pulley. Make sure it's okay. It is. Yep. Everybody's happy. All right.
Almost there.
I say that, but probably jinxed myself. Put my 9mm in my harness. Let me plug in here. Plug my connector in the back of the alternator. Cover back on that. Ouch. Not a lot of room. There's not a lot of room in here. But it'll get it in there. Okay. Let me set my wire back on the positive post here. Right, now I can hook it up. Good. My boot back on there. My wires are back on. Bracket's back on. Belt's back on. Put my bracket back on now. Here. Okay. Now, let's get my tools out of here. Now we get to fight with this, which will leak some more. I'm gonna see if I can get this line over here. It'll go over because it came off, so we'll hook that back up before I, I can lay that down. Let me go get a pair of clippers and cut that cable tie off of there. Do that. Trying not to get too much power steering fluid over everything. Did pretty well so far. Probably just jinxed myself, but. Cable tie, keep it pointed up into the pan with that. Get my hose back on there. There we go. Thing of beauty. Sure I didn't damage that? No. I didn't squeeze it very tight. Just enough to try to keep it from leaking all over the place. Put my hose clamp back on. Past it. Here we go. Good. I will have to put some fluid in that, but I'll top that off. No big deal. Let's get it back in the bracket. Let's see if we can get it up here in the bracket now. Come on. All right, there's one. I'm gonna move my light from out of here. I gotta clip this back in place here. Just set that over here if I can. You might have to stay put for a minute. I'm wearing my face, which I don't need. Blind me. Get that clip back in there. There. Slide this down there. And we'll be putting some fluid in this. This is completely empty. This overflow is empty. I haven't checked the radiator, but it's obviously not full all the way up. It's right to the top of the radiator, though, so it's just a little low. Looks like Honda Blue, I believe. I'll check it, but I believe I have some of that here. We will fill that up as well, and I will fill power steering fluid, Honda power steering fluid, which I believe I have. If not, I'll get some. I believe I have some of that, too. That's it. I'm going to put the cover back on, obviously. Let me hook the battery back up. Let me see if I can find some power steering fluid for this. Start this up and see if it's charging. Better be. Should be. I'm gonna cover back on the front here. Just push it down in the back. There's two holes for it. Two stands. Go in these two holes. Line the fronts up here. There we go. Max in. These are just quarter turn. That's it. Don't crush them. I'm using this screwdriver. It's big and it's easy to use. That's it. It's in place. All right. We're gonna go across the battery here. This is an initial check. 14.2 2, 14.1 volts. So it's charging the battery. Was not doing that before. I'm going to hook the scanner up to it. Maybe go with a scope again and show the back of the alternator, but obviously it's charging. Take another look at the scanner with this and make sure everything's behaving, but it looks like it's working good now. I just wanted to show this. So the yellow trace here is that field wire, and you can see the duty cycle on this now, where it's shutting it on and off, going on and off as it's partially telling it to charge, where before it was at zero the whole time because it knew the battery was low, but now the battery's fully up to charge, and it's the computer is toggling the charging on and off. I really wanted to show that so you can see that it is basically a 5-volt square wave, the ECM controlling how much the alternator is going to charge. Well, that's it for this 2009 Honda Pilot alternator, new alternator. You can see it was charging at 14.2 volts. And I wanted to show that square wave after the alternator is working and responding and the computer actually controlling how much it's charging back to the battery. You can see that. Not a very hard job, a little tight getting in and out of it, but not bad. If you have to do this for your vehicle, I hope it helps you out. If you like the video, subscribe below. Thanks for watching.